everyone. This is Paul Navidad, professor of music at Orange Coast College in Costa Mesa, California, and Silverstein Pro Team member. And today, we are going to be test driving the all-new cryogenically treated prototype mouthpiece by Silverstein Works. Now, personally, I've been a big fan of cryogenic applications in musical instruments for many, many years, and I've actually had a number of my horns cryogenically treated. So I'm really excited about the opportunity to try out a mouthpiece which has been cryogenically treated. Now, of course, the best test for this would have been to try the mouthpiece out prior to its cryogenic treatment. However, today we are just going to report on our findings and see how it works out. So we hope you enjoy what we do today. For our tests today, we're going to be comparing a couple different mouthpieces. Obviously, we're going to be giving a listen to the cryogenically treated prototype that Silverstein has sent me. This is a cryo 4 ligature on it, and what I understand is this is an 8, meaning it's probably about a 110 opening. I'm going to be comparing it against my normal setup, which is a vintage Dukoff stubby from 1945 that's been opened up to a 99 and has an original Silverstein ligature on that. And let's tell you a little bit about the horns that we're going to be trying these on. This first horn that we'll be using for our tests happens to be a Sommer Mark VI 122,000 series that has been cryogenically treated. This was actually my main horn for about 11 years, and because of all the outdoor work I was doing, was exposed to a lot of the elements, eventually fell apart on me and had to be rebuilt from the ground up. It actually came apart in my hands on a gig outdoors. So in rebuilding it, I actually had it cryogenically treated and silver plated, and it's a wonderful playing horn. Our second horn for our test today is this Cuff Superba 1, which has also been cryogenically treated. For the better part of the last 5 years, this has been my outdoor horn, and it plays wonderfully. Our third and final horn that we will be testing our mouthpieces on today is actually brand new out of the box. This is the all-new Sax Dakota XR92 tenor saxophone in raw bronze, and it arrived earlier in the mail this week, so this is fresh and hasn't been set up yet. Now, I am a Sax Dakota performing artist, so once I have this cryogenically treated and set up by my techs, this will become my main performing horn, and the other horns will be relegated to my collection. Okay, just for a point of reference here, we're going to start off with my normal setup, which is a Dukoff stubby with a Rigotti Classic 3 light reed and a Silverstein ligature on a Mark VI. Now this is the all-new prototype cryogenically treated mouthpiece by Silverstein with a Silverstein Cryo 4 ligature and a Rigotti Gold 3 Strong Reed on the Mark VI.
Thank you.
do cuff on the Cuff Superba. Silverstein on the Cuff Superba. Here we have the Dukoff on the Sax Dakota XR92. Silverstein on the Sax Dakota. From a dimensional comparison between the two mouthpieces, there isn't too much of a difference. My Dukoff again is a 99, and the Cryo is supposedly an 8, which I'm assuming is about a 110. That being said, it didn't blow more open than I thought it would. Actually, was very comfortable, very comparable in blowing feel to the Dukoff. Blew a little bit more open, which is to be expected, and has a really huge cavernous sound and a very good response in the low end, especially. Really, the low end pops out very easily. Also has a nice, a little bit of a brighter sound than the Dukehoff. Definitely free response all across the board on this. From other dimensional perspectives, if you take a look, and again, you probably can't tell from this angle, the rollovers are pretty comparable between the vintage Dukehoff and the Cryo. There's just a little bit more of a baffle in the Cryo. And when it comes to your chamber sizes, the Dukehoff has, again, you probably can't see it from this angle. The Dukehoff has a slightly larger chamber than the Cryo. That said, the Cryo blows very, very warm and very rich and is a wonderful mouthpiece. And if Silverstein would allow me to keep it, I would keep it right now. So I think you guys are doing a great job with this mouthpiece. I do hope you bring them into production because I would definitely like to get one, possibly in a 100 or even a 105. But let's see how these work in the real world. Let's take this out in the field and see what it does out there. Hi, this is Paul Navidad at Silverstein Artists, and tonight I'm going to be field testing the new prototype cryogenically treated mouthpiece by Silverstein Works on a casual. Prototype cryo mouthpiece by Silverstein. So we'll be doing some section work with it in a pops orchestra. Sitting next to me in the section, and he's going to give you a few words about how the new mouthpiece sounds in a section context.
Hey, Paul, it sounded great. It was a big, warm, rich sound, and it really played well in the section.
Cool. Thanks, Greg. Hi, this is Paul Navarat, Silverstein artist, and I'm going to be field testing the new prototype.
Take three.
Hi, this is Paul Navarat, Silverstein artist, and I'm going to be. Saxophonist Greg Parman, and he's been sitting next to me in the section here, and he's just going to give you a few words about how the mouthpiece sounded in the section.
It sounded a little squirrely, like a chipmunk.